The Ministry of Education and Technical and Vocational Training would like to welcome 75 senior high school students who have chosen to explore the deeply satisfying and rewarding career of teaching through the Teacher Cadet Program. We take this time to officially install cadets from across our archipelago for the 2021-2022 academic year.
Hello, my name is Leia Ray Tucko of St. Augustine's College. I am so proud to be one of the newest teacher cadets. Here's a little about the program we have joined.
The Future Teachers of the Bahamas program is commonly called the Bahamas Teacher Cadet Program. It was established in February 1995. The principal focus of this program is to attract to the teaching profession students in the 10th, 11th, and 12th grades in government and independent secondary schools to the teaching profession. Students wishing to join the program apply online through the Ministry of Education's website or the Teacher Cadet Facebook page. After they have applied, the Administrative Office of the Teacher Cadet Program screens applicants to ensure that they meet the minimum academic requirements of 5 or more BJC subjects with a C grade or higher. 2 of these subjects must be mathematics and English language. Students whose applications meet this criteria are invited to an interview. During this interview, students explain why they wish to join the program and are given a comprehensive description of what is required of them if they are approved to join. The program is designed to expose students to fundamental pedagogical principles, provide opportunities for them to engage with educational professionals, and give them focused, controlled, practical experiences in the profession. In the 12th grade, cadets receive additional support in college readiness and assistance with BGCSE preparation classes. By the end of the 3-year program, cadets have received a wide range of knowledge and skills and are able to make an informed decision about whether or not to pursue a career in education. Those who go on to the University of the Bahamas School of Education are eligible for a stipend of $475 per month that they may use for books and other related expenses. The Future Teachers of the Bahamas program is supported by 23 teacher mentors across the country that mentor up to 8 students annually. In addition to enrichment teachers in mathematics, English language, science, history, and geography, the program is proud to boast that the current coordinator and 15 of the 23 teacher mentors were once teacher cadets themselves. The program has evolved in many ways throughout the years, from on-site to online, greater opportunities for practical experiences, smaller, more focused cohorts, and better preparation for university education. It now has as its focus the recruitment of more males to the teaching profession and the recruitment of more teachers in technical and vocational fields to the classrooms of the Bahamas, all in its commitment to live up to the Teacher Cadet motto, nurturing tomorrow's teachers today.
Hello. My name is Kai Taylor of Central Andrews High School. I am delighted to be a part of the Teacher Cadet program. This program has been inspiring students to become teachers for the past 27 years. Each week, cadets commit themselves to the fundamental principles of the Teacher Cadet program by reciting the Teacher's Cadet Pledge. Let's tune into Brene Roll of North Long Island High School, Lenique Sanders of the Mangrove Key High School in Andrews, and Burnett Larry of Preston Albury High School in Eleuthera as they recite the Teacher Cadets Pledge.
The Teacher Cadets Pledge. I pledge to strive for excellence in everything I do.
To be the student I would want to give my labor to.
To learn the pedagogy that will help me to excel.
To serve the students I will touch. To serve my country well.
With God's help to guide me, I will always keep in mind
that I should ever strive to be fair,
reflective,
honest,
kind, and one day as a teacher, remember to discern
the person who most wants to teach must never cease to learn.
Good evening. My name is Jasmine Clark of City Bethel Senior High School. As a new cadet joining the Teachers Cadet Program, I have already learned that teachers are learners. They stand out from every other profession. We have chosen to explore teaching because we recognize the fundamental importance of teachers in the formation of all other professions. Let's watch as LaShawn Roll of R.M. Bailey Senior High School, Carlia Elvis of Bahamas Academy, Renisha Pratt of Old Bay High School, and Fernell Nemo of Jack Hayward Senior High School recite the poem, I'd Rather Be a Teacher. After they are done, stay tuned as Kendall Gibson of North Eleuthera High School displays his talent with a musical selection.
I would rather be a teacher, a poem by Zatrice Alva.
I would rather be a teacher than a salesman, but he sells washing machines and fountain pens and cars and other material things, but I sell ideas.
I would rather be a teacher than a stenographer, for he helps write letters, but I help write prayers. He touches keys, but I touch lives.
I would rather be a teacher than an architect. Satisfactory as program of large constructions might be, for an architect helps build edifices, but I help build character. Edifices endure for a time, but character endures throughout eternity.
I would rather be a teacher than an artist, for an artist paints pictures on canvas, but I paint pictures on the memories of little children. An artist makes impressions on tablets of clay, but I make impressions on the soul.
I would rather be a teacher than a bookkeeper, for he balances accounts, but I help balance lives.
I would rather be a teacher than a great business executive, for he works with facts and figures and lifeless coins, but I work with minds that open, futures that unfold, and principles that grow.
I would rather be a teacher than an accomplished musician, for a musician plays on violin strings and piano strings, but I play on heart strings.
I would rather be a teacher than an orator, for an orator stirs adults to applause and admiration, but I stir little children to right choosing and noble thinking.
I would rather be a teacher than a potter, for he shapes vessels of clay, but I shape destinies.
I would rather be a teacher than an interpreter, for he interprets words and ideas, but I interpret motives and purposes and endeavors.
I would rather be a teacher than an archaeologist, for he unearths buried treasures, but I unearth talents.
I would rather be a teacher than an explorer, for he explores uncharted seas, but I explore uncharted minds, discover treasure islands and continents of untold possibilities.
I would rather be a teacher than a statesman, for he deals with finished citizens, I deal with future citizens.
I would rather be a teacher than a scientist, for he studies the wonders of rock and the beauty of stars and the miracle of plants and the glories of the sky. I deal with that which is still more miraculous in throbbing human hearts, unfolding human lives, and the formation of lifetime characters.
I would rather be a teacher.
What do teachers make? Up next, with a dramatic presentation to answer this question, is Lorenzo McCoy Jr. of Nassau Christian Academy and Stanford McIntosh Jr. of Sirlin C. Boodle High School in Abaco. Let's tune in.
Good evening, Mr. McCoy. How are you doing?
I'm wonderful, thank you.
We are here tonight for your interview to the Bahamas Youth Influencers Association. Now, you said that you work as a pedagogical specialist.
Yes, that is right.
And what exactly does that involve?
Well, I assess the needs of students, diagnose the best way to approach their learning needs, and design appropriate instructional approaches in order to help them to meet learning goals.
Okay, and where do you work?
At National High School.
National High? Wait, you're a teacher?
Yes, my profession is commonly known as teacher.
Oh, I see. Well, I'm not sure you're quite what we're looking for, Mr. McCoy. We are looking for influencers, someone our young people can learn from about the best decisions to make in life. And I mean, really, what's a kid going to learn from someone who decided his best option in life was to become a teacher? You know what they say about teachers? Those who can do, those who can't teach. Seriously, Mr. McCoy, you may not even be able to meet the membership dues. I mean, what do teachers make?
You want to know what I make? I make kids work harder than they ever could. I make kids sit through 40 minutes of study hall in absolute silence. I make parents see their children for who they are and what they can be. You want to know what I make? I make kids wonder. I make them question. I make them criticize. I make them apologize and mean it. I make them write. I make them read, read, read. I make them spell words like definitely beautiful, deathly beautiful, definitely beautiful, over and over and over again until they never misspell either of those words again. I make them show their work in math and hide it on their final draft in English. So if you want to judge my ability to be a successful influencer in your organization, let me break it down to you. I am a teacher. I make a difference. You have a good evening, sir.
Mr. McCoy? Teachers make a difference. Approved.
Our teacher cadets are mentored each week by a fantastic group of advisors. These wonderful educators have gone above and beyond the call of duty in ensuring that our cadets complete all curriculum requirements and are able to perform their tasks well. We applaud the efforts of the enrichment teachers of the Teacher Cadet Program for making a difference in the lives of future teachers. Enrichment teachers, you have made a difference.
This song is for those who inspire us today, who always lend a helping hand to help show us the way. This song is for those who see their students through the tough times in their lives. For that we say thank you. You have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you're as proud of me. I am proud of you. This song silent cries. Who stepped in to wipe the tears from the children's eyes? For those who gave us a safe place to grow, a place for us to call our home forever, we will know that you have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you. This song is for those who taught us right from wrong, who taught us much more than their craft to help our minds grow strong. This song is for those who guide us through and through, so that we can make a life for that we say thank you. You have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you. As I look back on my life and to the path within my reach, I hope I can change the life of those that I teach. I can make a difference. All I do is try to see a different world through the children's eyes. And I will always be there in everything I do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you. Everything I do, I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you.
Yes, teachers make a difference, and we applaud all of those that are chosen to make a difference in the lives of students in the future. Please stay tuned as the Minister of Education and Technical and Vocational Training offer words of encouragement to our newest teacher cadets.
More than two decades ago, the Ministry of Education established the Future Teachers of the Bahamas program in an effort to encourage the brightest and best students to become teachers. All these years later, the Ministry of Education and Technical and Vocational Training remains committed to the objectives of this program: to identify and attract adequate numbers of talented and intellectually competent high school students who display a positive attitude toward teaching as a career. This year, 75 of you, the brightest and best from public and independent schools across the Bahamas, have joined the thousands of students who have experienced education through the eyes of a teacher. Many of you have joined searching. You're trying to determine whether teaching is the right profession for you. To you, I say thank you for considering a career in education. The almost 4,000 teachers across the nation will confirm that if chosen, you will find teaching to be a most fulfilling career. Most of you have already made the decision to become a teacher. Congratulations. You are joining the greatest profession in the world, a profession that makes all other professions possible. Whether you are searching or certain, the journey to becoming an educator of the highest quality will not be easy. No truly worthwhile endeavor ever is. But I encourage you to remain true to your goal. The nation needs young, passionate leaders such as yourselves to lead our children in the future. During your time in the program, you will complete many tasks and learn many useful things. I challenge you to reap the greatest benefits from the experience. Take advantage of BGCSE classes offered exclusively to you. Attend virtual meetings and workshops. Participate in cadet national competitions. Network with like-minded, positive future teachers from across the archipelago. I take this time to thank the coordinator of the Teacher Cadet Program and the 23 teacher mentors that spend hours each week mentoring these teacher cadets. Your contribution to the future of education in this country is greatly appreciated. To the newest teacher cadets being installed tonight, I pray that your experience in the teacher cadet program is fulfilling and provides you with many memorable opportunities. As you tutor a child this year, as you plan lessons, create virtual classrooms, and design educational resources, remember the goal to become an educator of excellence that will make a positive difference in the lives of children is what's on the table. One day, you will be teachers that will help the Ministry of Education and Technical and Vocational Training to fulfill its mission to provide all children in the Bahamas an opportunity to receive a quality education that will equip them with the necessary beliefs, attitudes, knowledge, and skills required for life, both in a democratic society guided by Christian values and in an interdependent, changing world. I wish you all the best. Good night, and thank you.
Thank you, Minister. Your words will remain with these teacher cadets long after they have completed their university studies and stand in our classroom as teachers.
And now, the coordinator of the Teacher Cadet Program, Mrs. Demetria Rule, will introduce us to the newest cadets of the Future Teachers of the Bahamas Program.
The Future Teachers of the Bahamas Program welcome the following cadets that have joined cohorts across the archipelago. Joining cohort number one, led by Ms. Asia Gibson, are Ms. Juisha Bain of the St. Anne's High School, future primary school teacher, Ms. Zoe Redhead of the St. Anne's High School, future art teacher, Mr. Tashawn Roker of the St. Anne's High School, future primary school teacher, Ms. Aaliyah Pinder of the Atlantic High School, future primary school teacher, Ms. Lene Miller of the Atlantic High School, future primary school teacher. Joining cohort number two, led by Ms. Jakia Charlton, are Maya Lewis of Queens College, future primary school teacher, Cheyenne Chipman of Queens College, future primary school teacher, and Leah Ray Tucker of St. Augustine's College, future Spanish teacher. Joining cohort number three, at the St. George's Senior High School, led by Ms. Deandra Sands, are Anaya Young, future mathematics teacher, and Brielle Moore, future mathematics teacher. Joining cohort number four at the North Eleuthera High School and led by Ms. Danair Munnings are Lauren McSweeney, future music teacher, Aaron McCartney, future mathematics teacher, Tishe Brown, future science teacher, Kendall Gibson, future music teacher, and Kezia Johnson, future health science teacher. Joining cohort number five at the Jack Haywood Senior High School, led by senior teacher Mrs. Jennifer Wiley, are Fernell Nemore, future biology teacher, Loyelle McCartney, future music teacher, Tanaya McIntosh, future computer science teacher, Jada Dean, future social studies teacher, Erica Dean, future mathematics teacher. Joining cohort number six at the Samuel Guy Pinder Comprehensive School and led by Ms. Michaela Higgs-Rowe is Aliana Henry, future English language teacher. Joining cohort number seven at the Central Eleuthera High School and led by Ms. Parry Sands-Culmer are Jarell Stubbs, future psychology lecturer, Jazara Taylor, future history teacher, Savannah Monroe, future business studies teacher, Valia Fernander, future mathematics teacher, not pictured is Ms. Relisha Maycock. Joining cohort number eight at the C.C. Sweeting Senior High School and led by Miss Ariadne Munnings are Tanisha Thompson, future business studies teacher, Danico Charles, future religious studies teacher, and Derenice Young, future visual arts teacher. Not pictured are Tianne Cohen and Prashe Smith. Joining cohort number 9 and led by Miss Shanique Rowell are Miss Favor Moss of the C.I. Gibson Senior High School, future English language teacher. Miss Carlisa Wright of the C.R. Walker Senior High School, future technical studies teacher. Miss Rainisha Neely of the C.R. Walker Senior High School, future art teacher. Joining cohort number 10 is Miss Audenique Farrington of the C.R. Walker Senior High School, future mathematics teacher. Also from C.R. Walker are Miss Trine Archer, future social studies teacher, Miss Tanisha Gibson, future science teacher, and Miss Tyra Brown, future language teacher. Not pictured is Mr. Gerald Bethel. Joining cohort number 11 at the R.M. Bailey Senior High School and led by Mr. Sidney Sawyer are LaShan Rowell, future science teacher, Trishana Ramming, future history teacher, Ocala Pinder, future religious studies teacher, Vernita Knowles, future business studies teacher, Miracle Thompson, future preschool teacher. Not pictured is Miss Crystal Bethel. Joining cohort number 12 at the Huntley Christie High School and led by Miss Shanique Hart are Paige Lewis, future religious studies teacher, Ellie Evans, future mathematics teacher, Marichelle Hinsey, future science teacher, and Maria Adams, future primary school teacher. Joining cohort number 13 at the Old Bite High School and led by Miss Anthony Gilbert are Marisha Pratt, future English language teacher, Ida Johnson, future biology teacher, Lakeitha Brown, future Spanish teacher. Joining cohort number 15 and led by Ms. Van Ray Bastian are Wayne Rowell of the Ellen Coakley High School, future religious studies teacher, Letitia Sayers of the Ellen Coakley High School, future primary school teacher, Taquana Curry of the Preston Albury High School, future art teacher, Renee Rowell of the North Long Island High School, future history teacher, and Burnett Larry of the Preston Albury High School, future religious studies teacher. Joining cohort number 15 with Ms. Michaela Wells are Aria Brown of the R.N. Gomez All-Age School, future English language teacher, Dialenique Johnson of the R.N. Gomez Comprehensive School, future religious studies teacher, Ms. Jayana Brown of the R.N. Gomez Comprehensive School, future music teacher, Asia Darville, the 8 Mile Rock High School, future mathematics teacher, and Lanique Sanders of the Mangrove Key High School, future science teacher. Joining cohort number 16 at the Sherlyn C. Boodle High School and led by Miss Anya Mills are Odell Cox Jr., future music teacher, Raynell Young, future mathematics teacher, Stanford McIntosh, future music teacher. Joining cohort number 17 at the Central Andros High School and led by Ms. Kendra McIntosh are Kai Taylor, future biology teacher, and Yvonne King, future biology teacher. Joining cohort number 18 and led by Mr. Matteo Barry are Ms. Angel Maycock of Aquinas College, future preschool teacher. Not pictured are Alicia Eldon and Ashley Burrows, also of Aquinas College. joining cohort number 19, and led by Miss Anari Neely, is Peronique Pierre-Lewis of the Anatole Rogers High School, future primary school teacher. Joining cohort number 20, with Miss Holly Riley Woodside, but not pictured, are Zion Demerit and Annie Huish. Joining cohort number 21, and led by Miss Tyra Cox, are Zaria Adderley of the Talios Christian School, future mathematics teacher, Morgan Knowles of the C.W. Saunders Baptist High School, future mathematics teacher, Trishay Clark of the Alpha Preparatory Academy, future mathematics teacher, Carlia Elvies of Bahamas Academy, future mathematics teacher, Lorenzo McCoy of the Nassau Christian Academy, future primary school teacher. And joining our newest cohort at the C.V. Bethel Senior High School, and led by Miss Kellyanne Tracy Russell, are Jajene Clark, future English language teacher, Tavara Roll, future mathematics teacher, Ryan Munnings, future history teacher, and not pictured is Miss Ciara Gardner, future cosmetology teacher. We welcome all of these new cadets that are joining the already existing 52 cadets in the Teacher Cadet Program.
This brings us to the end of our virtual installation ceremony. Remember, teachers make a difference. Send a word of encouragement to a teacher you know today.